Let us discuss the theory of social action and Wersten method as given by Max Weber. So what is social action according to Weber? Let us consider an example where you are upset because of something and you go to your room alone and you cry there. So according to Max, even when there is a meaning behind your action, it will not be a social action because you are doing it in isolation. You are crying in your room alone. According to Max Weber, this is not a social action because in a social action, there should be a meaningful orientation as well as there should be two or more than two people. Therefore, the relationship with action of others is also very important. He has talked about four types of social action, which are Zweck-rational social action, Wirth-rational social action, affective social action, and traditional social action. Let us discuss them one by one. Zweck-rational social action, as the name suggests, it talks about the best means to achieve the goal. And there is always a correlation between means and the goals. For example, a student working very hard, studying for very long hours for his exams in order to get good marks, or a doctor performing a surgery to save a person's life. Coming to the second one, Wirth rational social action, it talks about values and the expected behavior of people. The society has laid down different kinds of rules and norms for the people to adhere to. And when the people follow those rules, they benefit the society as well. For example, when I am giving charity to the society for the welfare, it will be known as a Wirth rational social action. Third is affective social action. Affective social action, where there is a role of emotions and feelings. So when we are laughing with our friends, it will be an affective social action. And if I'm laughing alone at something, maybe a joke that I read in my mobile, it will not be a social action. The last is traditional social action. This kind of social action, it keeps getting carried forward from one generation to another and is guided by customs and habits. For example, paying respect to your elders. Your mother taught you this because she was also told to do this by her elders. And celebrating festivals as a family. This is also a kind of traditional social action. Now, this theory was criticized on various grounds like social action where Weber has talked about that it cannot be done in isolation, but Parsons said that it can be done in isolation and it should only be a conscious action and then it will be considered as a social action. The second criticism is by Habermas, who has talked about dramaturgical action, where he said that the society tells you certain roles that you have to play in the society and throughout your life. So when you play that role, that is social action. So in order to study social action, Max suggested two methods. First is ideal type method, which is the comparison method, and there is a PPT regarding the same in a different video. Please refer to it. And the second one that we are going to discuss today is Wersten method, that is the empathy method. So Weber said that sociology is a science and it attempts to understand the social action in an interpretive way. That means it tries to understand why one is doing what he is doing and it interprets the meaning behind every action by the members of the society. So it tries to understand human behavior. As we know that social science is different from natural sciences, where you can conduct experiments in a lab, but you cannot conduct experiments on the humans in a lab, and the results may also always vary when you are trying to research something based on humans. So Sociology or social sciences, they always need their own independent methods as they could not rely on natural sciences. So, Worston method is the empathetic understanding of human behavior, where the researcher tries to understand what is the meaning behind a social action and why one is doing something from the actor's perspective and not the researcher's perspective. So, the process of meaningful understanding of an action done by the actor is Worston method. Coming to the characteristics of Worston method, it is understanding the action of actor. Researcher puts himself in the shoes of the subject or the actor. The interpretation of the action is done through causal analysis, that is, cause and effect method is used. For example, if I am not studying when I have my exam tomorrow and the other person is studying very hard for the same exam, so the researcher would try to understand why one person is not putting any efforts and why the other person is putting so much efforts. In this process of interpretation, the researcher has to remain objective and value neutral. That means he should not be biased, he should not be subjective, and he should remain objective. There should be no feelings or manipulation when he tries to conduct the research. Now, what is the purpose of this social action? This social action has to be there because there is a purpose. Whenever somebody does something, there is a purpose behind it. For example, if there is a football match and the team is practicing for really long hours every day, but they are still losing the game. They still lost the final match. So the researcher will try to understand, why did this happen? How did this happen? There must be something wrong. And when he talks about the research, he has to remain value neutral. He should not get manipulated by the actor. So, to become value neutral, after all, the researcher is also a human. He might be biased. He might feel sentimental or emotional for the actor. So, therefore, vigorous training is required for the researcher to help him stay objective and not get biased. Now, coming to the criticism of Worston method. First is, neutrality or objectivity is not always possible because we all have different nature, we all are humans, and we could get affected by emotions. Actor can manipulate the researcher. If the actor is smart, he can easily manipulate the researcher. The hangover of natural sciences is evident. So, as we discussed, in natural sciences, we can conduct experiments, and when Max Weber talks about Worston method, he talks about objectivity, neutrality, and conducting experiments. So, these are also the parts of natural sciences only, because when we talk about humans, it is not possible to remain very objective. Therefore, there is still a hangover of natural sciences. Now, we'll conclude this lesson. Social action. Social action has helped in the development of sociology as an independent subject free from natural sciences. This concept is till date very important in the study of sociology. Worston method, which is a way of studying social action, is still very important and we use it in our daily lives. How do we know that someone is trying to say something without using his words? We understand them. We understand if someone is doing something, we try to understand the emotions behind it. So all of this is Worston method. If someone is really sad, we try to, you know, empathize them, not just sympathize, but empathize them also. So this is all Worston method that we use in our daily lives. For this contribution, Weber was known as the father of interpretive sociology. I hope you got this lecture. Let us discuss some questions now. In sociology, who for the first time emphasized social action as the basis for theory. So Max Weber was the first thinker who emphasized social action as the basis of theory in sociology. Next question is, the action of a manager who wishes to increase productivity is called dash action. Answer will be emotional. Why? Because in order to increase the productivity, he will motivate and encourage his workers and also feel motivated himself to perform better. Last question is, who among the following conceives of sociology as a comprehensive science of social action? Answer will be Max Weber, who has talked about the interpretative and comprehensive science of social action. Thank you.